Okay. All right, sister.
For Sophia DeCaro, political campaigns are a family affair.
Well, I can't thank you enough for your support. You guys have been
throughout the fall, DeCaro, her husband Robert, and their three kids caravan through Utah's State House District 31.
Awesome.
Thank you so much. We appreciate it.
For DeCaro, who previously worked for four governors, the family's full court press is designed to hold the seat she won 2 years ago.
You know, this campaign politics world, it's one of those things that you can't really describe unless you experience it for yourself.
As a Republican in Utah, DeCaro was part of the state's majority in the House of Representatives. But as a woman in Utah politics, she's a rarity. Nationally, about a quarter of all state legislators are women, with six senators in its 29-member Senate and just 10 representatives in its 75-member House. Utah has one of the lowest percentages of female legislators in the country. Yet this low percentage lags behind what's happening in the workforce. 60% of Utah's women are participating in the labor market.
Why do you think so few women are involved in state legislature here in Utah?
I think there's a number of factors that play into that question. We have a part-time legislature. It is full-time intensity for a 45-day period, so your family situation has to be such that you're able to accommodate that kind of schedule. You have to have the availability of time, and you have to have the financial ability to make it work. You're not paid very much as a legislator.
DeCaro says her ability to make the arrangement work for the family is largely due to the support she receives from her husband.
Do you ever find yourself contemplating the gender questions that surround campaigns? Does that come into your world at all when you're thinking about...
Initially when I ran for office, that did come up in our caucus meetings. Are you going to be able to manage your family?
Do you think if you were a man, they would have asked you those questions?
No, I don't.
You can't discuss women in Utah politics without addressing the role of the state's dominant religion, the Mormon Church.
Majority of the population identifies as a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. At the same time, Utah has one of the lowest percentages of women in state legislature. Is it fair to ask if there's a correlation between the two?
I think it's a fair question to ask how the culture impacts the greater community.
Ali Isom is the church's director of family and community relations.
We're having the conversations within the church as an employer, but we're also having the conversation within the church as a faith-based group.
Although the Mormon Church currently does not allow women to become priests, she believes the state would benefit with more women in politics.
We're looking at what are the cultural barriers that might inhibit women from stepping up, and do they need a little encouragement? Do they need to know that they make a difference? We need women to recognize the value they add to public policy conversations. The questions they ask are so important. And to understand they make a meaningful difference when they step up and engage. But cultural change sometimes takes some time.
With permission from the church, Isom sits on the executive committee of Utah's Women's Leadership Institute, a coalition formed by the Salt Lake City business community, working to train Utah women for senior leadership positions, both in business and politics.
There will be people when you run for office that will ask you how you feel about certain things.
Today is the first day of their political development series, designed to train women of any party affiliation how to run for office. The six-month program is led by the Institute's CEO, Patricia Jones.
Women make up more than half of the population, and yet we have such a small percentage of women who are making policy decisions. You know, I think it was Oprah Winfrey once said that politics is social work with power.
First elected in the year 2000, Jones spent 14 years as a Democratic state representative and state senator.
The first race that I had, I didn't know what I was doing. You know, I knew that I had to walk door to door because I was a Democrat. I ran as a Democrat in a Republican area.
Understanding how the system works is really important to you personally.
Jones spent much of her time in office fighting for increased funding for public education. She says while she was warmly received by her male colleagues, collaboration was often easier with women.
I saw that personally. You saw women, you know, working together on both sides of the aisle when I was in the legislature.
Utah, like many states, does not require companies to provide paid family medical leave for the arrival of a new baby or to care for a sick relative. Utah workers benefit only from the federal law, which allows for 12 weeks of unpaid leave from their jobs.
What's the causation or correlation between the lack of women within state legislature and a lack of family policies within the state of Utah. Is there a correlation between the two?
Yes, absolutely. There has to be. I mean, I could give you countless stories about my own personal experience. You're often either the only woman or one of very few women in a committee. And these are committees that are discussing issues that are of primary importance to women.
Advancing women's issues through the legislature is a goal of the Utah Women's Coalition, run by Stephanie Pitcher.
If we don't have women up there speaking and lending that perspective to the issue, then we're not going to have a policy that is representative and comprehensive to the entirety of Utah's population.
Last year, Pitcher worked with a Republican senator to pass a bill requiring employers to provide reasonable accommodations for pregnancy and breastfeeding in the workplace.
I'm interested in exploring what...
This year, she's working with Democratic State Representative Angela Romero to resurrect a bill granting 6 weeks of paid parental leave for state and university employees.
I think states like Utah want to show that they're fiscally conservative, but I flip that and say, well, if we really invest in our employees and we provide them with these incentives, then they're going to be happy in their jobs, they're going to have happier families, and we're going to have a healthier economy long term.
Two prior attempts to pass a paid family leave bill in Utah have failed. Today, in this interim session, the bill is once again under economic scrutiny.
Has anyone taken a look at that and the cost of that versus a first benefit?
That's my concern as well, as we look at the fiscal side of this very carefully.
Despite those questions, there was one receptive Republican representative, Sophia DeCaro.
I know I'm a little bit more interested in the mechanics because I would like to see something like this work, and I would hate for it to get hung up due to mechanics, and maybe I can help take a look.
And it's not about necessarily accommodating the woman. It's about accommodating the family, because the husband's impacted just as much. It's a family affair. So if we have a welcoming environment for family, I think that that would only help the state.
Women tend to migrate towards certain issues, whether it's public ed or health. It's issues where, you know, childcare, you know, family leave and that sort of thing, because those are the lives that they've lived. To have that power to actually make change is really what's important, that women understand the power that you can have. And there's nothing wrong with the word power.
Suzanne's running for, you're running for the House, aren't you? The House.
Suzanne Harrison is one of 40 women in Jones's political development series this year.
Thank you all for coming.
An anesthesiologist and member of the Mormon Church, the first-time candidate is running as a Democrat for State House District 32, just outside of Salt Lake City.
So you are running for office for the first time. Why?
Mostly because I'm a mom, and this is a priority for our family. We have some of the largest class sizes in the whole country, and we have the lowest in per pupil spending in the whole country. And I feel like that's wrong. That's not where my values are. That's not my priority as a mom and as a doctor. I value public education, and I want that to be a priority in this state.
This November, women are competing for 35 seats in the Utah House and Senate. If, in the unlikely event they win all 35, this would more than double the percentage of women in state government. But women would still only occupy a third of the Utah state legislature.
I'm an anesthesiologist. I'm a physician. My first priorities are to families and to my patients. And we could use some more of those kind of viewpoints in the legislature. There's a lot of people in real estate, a lot of people that are developers. There are not very many physicians, and there's not a lot of moms, and those perspectives really matter.